Hi, I'm Dory Frame, and I'd like to share some lessons I've learned while living with an aging and ill pet. This is Alexander Reykjavik. He's one of my life teachers. He was my navigational service dog for 9 years. He retired May 2017, 1 month after his 11th birthday, when he suddenly showed some physical changes. His mobility began to decrease as he showed signs of degenerative myelopathy, or DM. DM is a deterioration of the nerve sheaths that innervate the muscle. It leads to gradual paralysis. But this story is not about that. It's about the most amazingly fun year we have had together since then. Well, I should say, it's about me getting my act together and then having a fun year, because my first reaction was not pretty. My initial response was one of sadness, self-pity, and fear. Sadness for him, for his diminishing mobility. Self-pity for me, because I was going to lose him. And fear of the unknown, of what every day would be like until I did lose my soulmate. Fortunately, he and my wiser self got through to me, and I was able to flip the script. I almost subtitled this video, Finding Joy in Living with a Dying Pet, but it didn't sound right, because he's not dying. He's still living. I've learned many things from my big little brother, as I like to call him. I've learned that he has a giant heart, an amazing spirit, and a great ability to communicate directly with me. But this year, I learned some new things. Here are four important lessons that came up this past year and a half. Little bit of love. Little bit of love. Little bit of love. Little bit of love. Every little bit of love. Little bit of love. Little bit of love. Little bit of love. In living with Reykjavik over the past year and a half, since he started to show the signs of DM, I've learned so much, and it's been a joyous time. There's four main lessons I would say I've learned in living with him. And the first one would be living in the present. This is good advice for anybody at any time, in any situation, but especially now, because I found the first thing I did was picture what life was going to be like without him, and I was sad. I would picture that Facebook post telling all our friends and all his friends that he had transitioned, and I just felt bad inside, and every day, as I dealt with him, I felt bad. And I realized this can't go on. I can't live like this with him. I'm wasting precious time. So I realized I really needed to learn to live in the moment and to focus on now. The worst thing you can possibly do is mourn for your pet while they're still here beside you and not be fully present with them. So what I decided to do is just be in the moment with him. I take him to the park. I take him swimming, we do water workouts, and the amazing upside of that is that he is doing so much better now than I ever imagined he would be doing. I've learned to sit quietly with him, to watch him, and then to just facilitate in the moment, help him with what he needs. I don't need to plan the future. I don't need to spend hours online researching his problems and what our next steps are and our future treatments. All I need to do is be with him. And what I've found is that if I watch him, I can see the perfect role model for me. He lives in the moment. And when I'm in the moment with him, it's nothing but joy. Little bit of love. Little bit of love. Little bit of love. Little bit.
bit of love, little bit of love, every little bit of love.
The second thing I learned in living with Reykjavik during this time is that I could rewrite our story. It's really interesting to hear how you talk about things, and it's a great reflection of how you feel about them inside. And I also feel that how you talk about things kind of brings it into your life. So I decided I had to quit telling people all about his malady when they were asking questions about him. The more I went on about degenerative myelopathy and how it was affecting him, the more it affected me. And I don't feel like it was good for him either. So I just started rewriting the script and presenting ourselves differently when we'd walk through the neighborhood. Instead of worrying about what the neighbors were going to see and say and feel sorry for him, I decided I would be as happy as he is. And I would expect them to see that, not what he was going through. Right, Reykjavik? Yeah. So instead of saying he has DM, or he's suffering from DM, I would say, look how happy he is. He's 12, he's lived an amazing life, and he's still wanting to get up and run around. Come on, Papa. Telling our own story also pertained to what I was thinking and feeling inside. I realized it was really important how I spoke, not only to people externally and in front of him, but also how I talked to myself, even inside my own head. I had to let go of perfectionism. There were days when he would have accidents in the bed, and I realized I didn't need to tell a story about that. I just needed to clean it up and go on. And not care about it the way he doesn't care about it. It made my life fun not having to worry about being perfect with him when I realized that he could fall down, I could help him up, and it was all good. Occasionally when I help him up, I fall down too, and that's okay. He still appreciates the help.
Little bit of love. Little bit of love, little bit of love, little bit of love, little bit of love, every little bit of love, little bit of love.
The third thing I've learned in this year and a half with Reykjavik is keep your vibes high, aka don't depress your pet. It's so easy to be focused on our own woes about how our pet is doing, what we will do after they've transitioned. But think about how your pet feels, waking up every day to a sad sack who's just lamenting their demise. Not cool. It's really important to keep your vibe high. And we do this by focusing on the positive things, the good things that are happening, not the bad things that might happen. It's really important not to live in the shadow of worst case scenario. Stay in the moment with your pet. Think about how beautiful your time is. Think about how happy you are that you still have them. Now is the time to enjoy them. Everyone does better when they feel better. Think about how much better you feel physically when you're happy and when you're enjoying life, when you're out enjoying things that you love to do. Your pet's the same way. They do much better physically when they're in a positive atmosphere. When you feel better, they feel better, and vice versa. It's a happy cycle. So think about that. You're not only doing this for yourself, you're doing it for your pet. Your pet is really going to enjoy your time together, the last maybe months or weeks or days that you have, if you're enjoying the time too.
Little bit of love, 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 little bit of love. Every little bit of love. Little bit of love.
So the fourth thing I've learned in this past year and a half with Reykjavik is the toughest lesson for me, and that's to keep living my life. Once I found out that he had this illness, and I knew that he would be possibly transitioning in 6 months to a year, I wanted to stop everything and just be sad and just help him all the time and kind of put my life aside. Number one, that makes you so tired and so unfulfilled, and you don't have much to give. It's really important to do things that bring you joy so you can be there for your pet. I had a trip scheduled to Paris when I first found out about Reykjavik's illness, and I canceled it. I thought I needed to be home with him 24/7. Fast forward a year later, I went on a beautiful trip to Australia that I loved, loved, loved. That was so fulfilling to me and gave me so much joy and growth. And I came back to him a better person. I was a better self. And he in turn had his own adventure with his caretakers, and we shared our new selves with each other. It was a wonderful time in my life, even though I stepped away from him for a moment. The difference that transpired in that year between canceling my trip to Paris and making the trip to Australia was mindset. I just decided to look at things differently. I'm focusing on the positive, focusing in the moment. I'm continuing to live my life in the moment with him. I'm continuing to do things that I love and facilitate him doing things that he loves. Both can coexist. It's not one or the other. Most importantly, I don't know how or when it will end, and I'm learning to live with that. I'm learning to live in the present and keep my life going. He had a diagnosis of 6 months to a year. It's a year and a half later, and he's still trotting around. So if I don't live my life, it's not fair to either of us. I need to be my best self to be present and joy with him.
Cause you are the champion. And I know, and I know, and I know, you're one in a million. Ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You say that I work too much. You say that I'm gone too much. But too much is never enough. When it's all for you, they wonder how we survive. They wonder how we are right. Never no sacrifice.
Cause it's all in for summary, you. Whatever is going on with your pet, be it old age, cancer, or terminal illness, don't be so busy running around, visiting vets, researching treatments, and picturing how sad you'll be without him, that you don't have time to just sit in the grass and ponder how amazing life with your pet is. I'd say I'm having way more fun now with Reykjavik than I did a year and a half ago at this time, because I took my own advice. I quit living in the fear of the future and started living as he does, in the joy of the moment. I communicated with Reykjavik as we were wrapping up this video and asked if there is anything he would like me to say to all of you. He said two things. Open your heart when you're with your pet. And secondly, share real moments. He is such a wise boy. I'm dedicating this video to Alexander Reykjavik, who is still very much alive. I love you, I feel loved by you, and I so appreciate you sharing your journey with me. Love you, Joy Boy.
Cause you are the champion. And I know, and I know, and I know, you're one in a million. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. You're the key to my kingdom. And I know, and I know, and I know, your love is unbeaten. I want you to be my number